Good morning, boys. Today we are going to start our lesson number 2, which is electricity. First, we will see the introduction about electricity. So, in 1882, first Thomas Alva Edison he lighted up about 14,000 bulbs in 9,000 houses in New York City. Where? In New York City. So there was the first thing he found out, electricity. So he lighted up 14,000 bulbs in 9,000 houses, and there electricity was the great invention to mankind. Okay. So what happened after that? In 1899, so that is 17 years later, from 1882, 17 years later, electricity was found in India. Okay, so this is the brief history about electricity, how it was found. So in 1899, after 17 years from 1882, electricity was found, first found in India. So what happened in 1899? In 1899, there was a thermal power plant launched. Thermal power plant launched in India in Calcutta. So, you all know what is thermal power plant, where we produce electricity from heat. Okay, from heat energy, we produce electricity. So, the thermal power plant was first launched in Calcutta in 1899. So what happened after that? This electricity was brought back to Madras city. So around 1900s. So around 1900s, electricity was found in Madras. So there also they have constructed a power plant, and from there electricity was distributed to various factories, industries, and for home domestic purposes, etc. So this was how electricity was found. So first electricity was found in New York City in 1882 by Thomas Alva Edison, where he lighted up 14,000 bulbs in 9,000 houses. And later, after 17 years, in 1899 only, first electricity was found out in India. So there they launched a thermal power plant in Calcutta in 1899. In later 1900s, electricity was found in Madras city. So there also they have launched a power plant, and from there power was distributed to various factories, industries, and for also for domestic purposes. Okay, so this is a brief history about how electricity was found. So how was electricity found? So electricity is a form of energy. So electricity is nothing but it is a form of energy. Like how we say heat energy, magnetic energy, so we have different types of energy. So electricity is also a form of energy. So you all know that you would have learnt in your previous classes from where electricity is produced. So we can produce electricity from water. So a very well power plant we have nearby our city in Mettur. There we have thermal power station and also hydroelectric power station. So from thermal power station, from heat we are producing electricity, and hydroelectric power station, from electricity, from water directly we are producing electricity. So how this electricity is produced? If you see in last term you would have learnt about atoms. Okay, so you know that what is an atom? All materials, all matter, matter, you know, that is solid, liquid, state. So our earth is we are surrounded by matter. Okay, all the small particles from large particles, everything is composed of matter. So you all know that matter is made up of a small material called, small element called atom. So all materials are made up of atom. So atom is the smallest indivisible particle. So I told you an example in previous term. While I am teaching this lesson about atom, you all know a graphite that is used in lead pencil, that is your normal pencil, which is made up of, that lead is made up of graphite. So that graphite, if we break into, or if we break, cut it with a knife, to the smallest fine particle, you can cut it into pieces, there will be a stage where you cannot divide it further. So that smallest tiny particle, which is called an atom. So you all know the structure of atom. So atom consists of a center part, nucleus. So this is nucleus, where you have two types of charges inside the nucleus. You have two types of charged particle, two types of particles, which is positively charged, and the other one is, other one possesses no charge. So this positively charged particle is nothing but proton P. So the particle which does not acquire any charge, it is nothing but neutron. So this is the structure of the atom. You can recall, so the atom, it has a center part, nucleus. So inside the nucleus, you have two types of particles, which is proton, which is positively charged, and neutron, there is no charge. So this is the center part of the atom. So surrounded, so the atom is surrounded with a circular orbit called, so this part which is the orbit, so surrounded the orbit, you have the negatively charged particles called electron. So electron, so this nucleus, sorry, this electron revolves around the nucleus in a circular path called orbit, where you have the negatively charged particles called electron. Electron which is negatively charged. Okay, so this is the structure of the atom. So atom consists of a center part called nucleus, where you have two types of particles called proton and neutron. Proton is positively charged and neutron acquires no charge. So this nucleus is surrounded in a, sorry, next particle, electron, is circulated around the nucleus in a circular path called orbit, where electron you have negatively charged. So these are the two types of charged particles. One is proton and electron, which is there in the atom. So why I am saying this in electricity lesson is, electricity is a form of energy that is associated with charges that exist inside the atom. So from this charges only electricity is formed. So electricity is a form of energy which is associated with some charges that exist inside the atom. So this is the definition for electricity. So electricity is a form of energy that is associated with electric charges that exists inside the atom. So inside the atom you have only two types of charged particles, one is proton and the other one is electron. Proton which is positively charged and electron which is negatively charged. So these two charges constitute the electrical energy. Okay, so regarding this electricity, I'll say you some example for the charges that is acquired in a body. So normally you take a comb and start rubbing it on your hair, start combing it on your dry hair. Okay, so then bring the comb and take a bits of paper and start placing the comb on the bits of paper. So once when the comb is thoroughly rubbed on the dried hair, what happens? Automatically the comb, the bits of paper starts sticking off to the comb. So this is because when a body is rubbed against another body, charges are acquired. So what happens if you rub it fastly? So for example, you can say rubbing your palm in a faster manner, what happens? There also you can say that charges are acquired. You can feel a form of heat around there around your palms when you are rubbing it faster. So there also a form of energy is formed. So here you can take this comb example, and also you can take a balloon, and if you start rubbing it on your hand, and if you are inflating it, and if you are sticking it on the wall without any adhesive or tape, you can stick it on as such, because when it is rubbed against another body, so I am rubbing it against my hand. So what happens? On continuous rubbing, charges are acquired. So whenever a body is rubbed against another body, okay, what happens? Charges are acquired. So this is how electricity is formed. Electricity is also a form of energy which is associated with these charges. Charges in the sense electric charges. So electric charges that exist inside the atom. So electricity is a form of energy that is associated with electric charges that exist inside the atom. Atom in the sense you have two types of charges. One is positively charged and the other one is negatively charged. Okay. Next. So how we will measure this charges? So electric charge is measured in terms of a unit called coulomb. Electric charge is measured in a unit called coulomb, C-O-U-L-O-M-B. Okay, so electric charge you can denote by the symbol small letter Q. Okay, electric charge is denoted by the letter small letter Q, and it is measured in a unit called coulomb. Okay, this can be denoted in small letter C. Okay, so this is how we measure electric charge in coulomb. So electric charge is denoted by the letter Q and coulomb is denoted by the letter C. So one unit of coulomb is nothing but, it is 6.242 into 10 to the power 18 protons or electrons. Okay, so how you will measure electric charge in terms of a unit called coulomb? So one unit of coulomb is nothing but, this is the value. So 6.242 into 10 to the power 18 protons or electrons. You just know the value of this coulomb. One unit of coulomb is nothing but 6.242 into 10 to the power of 18. PRE is nothing but, P is proton. Either it can be a positively charged or it can be a negatively charged, which is electron. Okay, so this is how we measure the unit of electric charge. Okay, coming to electric current, what is electric current? So if you want an electrical appliance to work, normally you can take your home appliance such as iron box. If you want that iron box to work or to operate, what you will do? You will first switch on the iron box then what happens? You must make sure that whether the current flow is there inside the iron box. So how you can measure that, or how you can know that whether current flow is there or not? So you can make sure when the iron box is getting hot. Okay, so automatically when there is a flow of current, automatically what happens? The iron box starts getting heated up. So by that you can know that there is a power supply in that iron box. So inside, what mechanism is happening is nothing but there is flow of electric charges. So how the electric current is measured is nothing but how much flow of electric charges are taking place. So flow of electric charges constitute electric current. So you can make sure that there is a flow of electric current if there is a flow in electric charges. If there is a flow of electric charges, that is positive charge or negative charge, if there is a flow of electric charges inside the device, then you can make sure that there is a flow of electric current. So you can see that in an device there will be a flow of electric charges from positive to negative or from negative to positive. So this is an electrical device. So this is the flow of electric charges. So once if you make sure that there is a flow of electric charge, you can make sure that there will be a flow in electric current. So how you will measure this flow of electric current? So this current, it is determined by the unit. For electric charge, you know that the symbol is Q. So for electric current, the symbol is capital I. It is measured in terms of capital I. So SI unit for measuring electric current. SI unit for measuring electric current is nothing but it is ampere, which is denoted by the letter capital A. So how do you measure electric current? In SI unit, in terms of ampere, symbol for electric current is I, symbol for ampere is capital A. Okay, so you have the formula for calculating the flow of electric current, that is nothing but how much amount of charge, that is Q, it is flowed across the surface within the given timing. So this is how you measure the electric current. So how much charge flows across the surface, okay, in a particular device within this given time. This is how you measure the electric current. So electric current is measured in terms of I. The formula is I is equal to Q divided by T. So automatically you know the what is I. I is nothing but electric current. So its unit is what? Ampere A. So Q is nothing but electric charge. Q is nothing but electric charge. So unit of electric charge is nothing but coulomb, which is small q. Then time t. So you already know the unit of time, which is second. So it is termed in small letter s. So how you will measure the electric current? I is equal to Q by T, where I is nothing but electric current. It is measured in terms of SI unit is ampere, which possesses the letter A, capital A. Then Q is nothing but electric charge. The unit of electric charge is coulomb. It is denoted by the letter small q. And time, you already know the unit of time is second, which is denoted by the small letter small s. So this is how you measure the electric current in terms of this given formula. So based on this formula, we'll solve a sum. Then you'll be clear with this concept, how the electric charges flow in a circuit. Okay, yes. So I'll write the sum. It is there in your book. When 30 coulomb of electric charge, when 30 coulomb of electric charge flows through a wire, flows through a wire in 2 minutes, in 2 minutes. Calculate the current in the wire. Calculate the current in the wire. So here I'll read the problem once again. When 30 coulomb of electric charge. So here they have clearly mentioned that the given electric charge is nothing but 30 coulomb. It is measured, electric charge is measured in terms of coulomb. So when 30 coulomb of electric charge, it flows through a wire. So I told you to ensure the flow of electric current, you must make sure that it is the flow of electric charges are there. So electric charge flows through this wire in how much time? In 2 minutes. So you need to calculate the current in the wire. So what is the given data here? So you are given with the data electric charge, which is nothing but Q, which is Q is equal to 30 coulomb. Then what is the given data? It flows through a wire in 2 minutes. 2 minutes. So time is also given. Time T is equal to 2 minutes. So time is always noted in the unit seconds. So this minutes, you must convert it into seconds. You know that 1 minute has 60 seconds. So 2 into 60 is equal to 120 seconds. Okay. So time, which is in minute, we convert it into seconds. So 2 into 60 is equal to 120 seconds. So you are given with two data, which is time and electric charge. So what you have to find out? To find is nothing but you have to find electric current. Electric current, which is I. Okay, which is I. So what is the solution? So we have seen with the formula, we have seen the formula calculating electric current. You have the formula I is equal to small q by t. So I is equal to, what is your q, which is 30, divided by time is 120 seconds. So 120, 30 divided by 120. So 0, 0 cancel, 3 divided by 12. So 3, if you divide by 12, what happens? 3 is smaller than 12. So you had a point over here and you can add 0. So 2 12s are 24. So remaining 6. So what happens? 6 is also smaller than 12. So again add a 0 here. So you have 5 12s are 60. So what is your value here? I is equal to 0.25. So how you will, what is the unit of electric current? It is nothing but ampere. So capital letter A. So I is equal to 0.25 ampere. So this is how you calculate the current that flows through the wire. So what is the given sum here? When 30 coulomb of electric charge flows through a wire in 2 minutes. So you need to calculate the current in the wire. So given data is nothing but you are given with the electric charge, which is denoted by the symbol Q, small q. It is nothing but 30 coulomb. So time given here is T is equal to 2 minutes. So since the formula is given in seconds, you have to convert this minute into second. So you already know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 2 into 60 is nothing but 120 seconds. So you have to find the electric current, which is I. So you have the formula with you. I is equal to Q divided by T. So I is equal to Q is nothing but 30 and T we have found it out. Here it is 120. So 30, if you divide by 120, it is nothing but 0.25. The unit of electric current is nothing but it is ampere. So this is the sum based on the given formula. Okay. So next topic we are going to see about the conventional current and electron flow. Next topic is nothing but the conventional flow and electric current. Sorry, conventional current. What is conventional current? And what is electron flow? So before the electron was discovered, scientists believed that there is a movement of positive charges alone in the atom. So what they have found out is this movement of positive charge is called conventional current. So previously, in last term, you would have studied about those theories where they have found first that the atom consists of only positive charges. So at that time, this conventional current was found out. Conventional current is nothing but movement of positive charges. Movement of positive charges. Okay. So after electrons were discovered, they found out that there is a movement of both positive and negative charges. So here, electron flow is nothing but it consists of both positive and negative charges. So for this, they have given a picture in your book. So current, you already know that it is the flow of electric charges. Electric charges in the sense it acquires both positive and negative charges. So here if you see, they have drawn a picture where you have a battery here. So battery, you know that it acquires positive and negative charge. So here battery, and it is connected with the bulb. So battery, it is connected with the bulb. So this is your bulb. So battery consists of positive and negative terminal, and this path is nothing but these are wires which conducts electricity. So conventional current is nothing but current flow takes place from positive terminal to negative terminal. The flow of current, when it takes place from this positive terminal and then moves on to the negative terminal, then it is called conventional current. So here the movement of positive charges dominates. Okay, so there will be a current flow from positive terminal then to negative terminal is nothing but conventional current. So electron flow, it is just the vice versa. Here also the circuit is connected with a battery which contains positive terminal and negative terminal, and it is, the circuit is connected with a bulb. So this is bulb and this is battery. So these are the conducting wires. So here how the current flow takes place? It takes place from negative terminal. So it starts moving from negative terminal then to positive terminal. If you see in conventional current, the flow takes place from positive terminal then it moves on to negative terminal. In electron flow, it is a vice versa. It starts flowing from negative terminal to, this is the difference between conventional current and electron flow. Okay boys, so conventional current is always opposite to the electron flow. How we are saying like that? Because in conventional current, the flow of current will be from positive to negative terminal. But in electron flow, the flow of current will be from negative to positive terminal. So conventional current is always opposite, flows in direction opposite to the direction of the electron flow. So this is the difference between conventional current and electron flow. Okay, so how you will measure electric current? So we have seen in the formula to calculate the current that flows in the wire. So how we will measure it? So there is a device called ammeter. Okay, so to measure electric current, we use a device called ammeter. So in page number 15, you can see the picture of an ammeter, where you have two terminals, both positive and negative terminal. So here you can say measurement of electric current is done using a device called ammeter. Okay, so here also you have both terminals in the device, positive and negative terminals. It is connected with the both terminals of the device. So to measure smaller currents, if you want to measure small amount of current, this ammeter is designated as milliammeter and microammeter. Smaller amount of electric current, this ammeter is designated as milliammeter and microammeter. Milliammeter and microammeter. So you have a certain formula to calculate the value of measuring smaller currents. You have problems also regarding that. So just I will let you know the formula, then in the next class we will solve the problem. Okay, just you know the formula alone to calculate the smaller amount of current, that is in terms of microampere and milliampere. So 1 milliampere, that is denoted by the symbol M, small m, and for ampere it is capital A. So 1 milliampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere. 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere, or it is written in other terms by 10 to the power of minus 3 is nothing but 1 by 1000 ampere. So this is one formula. Okay, in terms of milliampere, if you want to measure the current in terms of milliampere, this is the formula. 1 milliampere, that is denoted by the symbol small m and capital A, is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere, or it can be written as 10 to the power of 3 can be, minus 3 can be written as 1 by 1000. So power 3 is termed as 1 by 1000 ampere. In terms of milliampere, so in terms of microampere, 1 microampere. So for microampere, what is the symbol? It is denoted by a Greek symbol, micro, which is mu, and ampere, it is A. Mu A is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere, or 1 by, minus 6 means it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros ampere. It is nothing but 1 by 10 lakh ampere, or 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. So these two formulae you must keep in mind. So if you want to measure smaller amount of current, that is, this ammeter is designated as microammeter and also as milliammeter. So formula for milliampere and microampere is 1 milliampere, which is denoted as small m and capital A, is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere. 10 to the power minus 3 can be written as 1 by 1000 ampere. And this microampere, which is denoted by this Greek symbol mu, and for ampere it is A, is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. So for minus 6 can be written as, 10 to the power of minus 6 can be written as 1 by 10 lakh ampere. So this is the formula for calculating the current in smaller terms. So the problem we will solve in the next class. Okay, thank you boys.